about this camera in so long. It's literally dusty. I figured that we would do a little catch up. Basically, I'm in my second semester of my third year in law school. I'm sort of coming to the realization that time flies really quickly. It's kind of scary and I don't think I like it. I think for me, a lot of law school was sort of wishing that the time would just fly by faster, especially because one all year was all on Zoom. It was a little rough, not really the greatest experience at all, even though obviously everyone was trying their best to do the best that we could with what we were given. I literally cannot believe that I'm graduating this May. I try to live my life without much regret, but one of my regrets over the past couple years is not having documented more of my experience. Thinking back, at least personally, I've grown a lot, and I feel like that's true for most stages of my life. About to do my nails at home, so I had to apply some stick sunscreen on my hands. It's the first week back to school. It's been a lot of, like, I completely redid my schedule 11 p.m. last Sunday before the first day of classes, which made this week a little bit stressful. Not in the sense that there was a bunch of stuff I needed to get done, but just because I'm the type of person who I like to know exactly what I'm going to be getting myself into very far in advance. Schedule was a little, it's fine now, but it was just a little uncertain this week, and so that amped up my anxiety a bit. Anyways, last night, so it's Saturday, we went to a Harvard hockey game, which is the first school-related sports game I've ever been to, which is kind of crazy. I haven't been to a single Harvard Yale, which I really regret. Maybe I'll come back as an alum in the future. We actually went to a Harvard Yale like student held thing during the actual game at a local like bar. Pretty sure that's also where Eric got COVID right before Thanksgiving, which was not great. But anyways, hockey was really, really interesting. I am not a huge sports person at all. I was like going in, I had no idea what to expect. It was super exciting. Like football is really, really slow, I think. But in hockey, the puck is constantly moving. Like it's so fast. And then the players are just like sprinting on the ice and they like body slam each other, which I wasn't expecting. Like I didn't know that fighting was apparently like the norm in hockey. But it was really, really great. It was a really good game in the sense that, so it was against Colgate and they were leading like 2-0 for the first, I don't know what they're called, like the first 20 minutes. We came back so strong. I was really impressed. And the thing is the puck, like when it goes into the goal, it's so fast and you sort of like, I couldn't believe my eyes. We caught up. We ended up tying at the end. So it went into overtime. And the last, I think, goal we made was with literally, I think, 8 seconds left. So I could not believe my eyes when the puck went into the goal. I literally could not believe my eyes. It was so good. But it went into overtime, and that last goal was so good. I was not expecting, or like, I would have been totally okay if we'd lost in overtime, and then we won. So that was really great. And I think honestly, that was the first time I had ever felt any sort of school spirit, which is kind of crazy, but I get really into things when I get really into them. The end of the first whatever section, the first 20 minutes, it was like, I'm hockey's number one fan now. And I went and I bought a hat, a Harvard hat, because I didn't have any like school gear on. But anyways, that was a lot of fun. So I was like lying in bed last night trying to fall asleep and sort of just regretting not having taken more advantage of being here these past, like, I guess now 2.5 years. I'm basically going to resolve, this is my New Year's resolution, that I will be daily, hopefully will be a little ambitious, daily vlogging, mostly for myself so that I can have this little documentation to look at in the future. I don't really have any goals, I think, for this last semester. I've never been super okay, this is gonna sound a little I don't know, but completely honest, I've never been a huge overachiever. Like I don't set super high expectations for myself, and I feel like most of my life I've sort of just been really blessed in a way, which is how my parents and I have always talked about it. Like, I'm not particularly smart. I think I'm just lucky, and that might be a controversial thing to say. Growing up, I was never one of the smart kids. I always felt actually pretty stupid because I was put into an advanced math class at a young age, probably just by virtue of being Asian. And it's really funny because I'm horrible at math. Being in that class, I think this was starting in eighth grade, and I was in like advanced math called Math Rocks. Anyways, moral of the story is my self-esteem was destroyed by being in that advanced math class. I could go into a whole thing. I'm not particularly smart. I'm a hard worker, but I don't kill myself over things. And I'm just very blessed in, I feel like, all aspects of my life. I'm holding myself accountable to vlogging. If not daily, then at least very regularly. Yeah. And I guess I'll bring you throughout the day if we do anything interesting. Right now, I am waiting for my nails to finish curing. Our studio is literally tiny. That is one thing I'm very excited for. Moving to DC is finally having space like that is small. And I'm doing my reading at the same time. But the plan is to walk to Back Bay to get late lunch, early dinner. We haven't gotten ice cream yet since Eric has been back, so that is a priority. We're probably gonna stop by and grab like a cone, one for each of us. Okay, we don't share. Classic. Too many cookies on top, fuck up on the bottom.
Oh, I have too many cookies on top and then the PB banana fluff on the bottom. So it is Sunday afternoon. We did laundry this morning and we were gonna go to Brookline lunch, but it's already 2 p.m. So now we're getting Korean food at Seoul Sejong.
And Eric helped me with my deals homework this morning, which is very nice.
Yeah, it was like a HBS case kind of situation.
We learned all about preferred
liquidation preference.
Is that what it's called? Preferred, deferred liquidation preference?
Preferred.
Preferred liquidation preference.
Yeah, so I learned it. And so we're like maybe 5 to 10 minutes away from our lunch dinner spot.
Excited! And I think one of these to start off with.
Like the spicy beef broth with shredded beef and vermicelli, and then we got a kimchi pancake. And then we got makgeolli, which is like sparkling rice wine, some kind of alcohol.
But then when he asked for IDs, I realized I left my wallet at home, so. So the banchan arrived, and look at this gigantic bottle of rice wine.
Okay. definitely think they're... Oh my gosh, what's wrong with my hair? Their strength is in their soups. I think Sojung Deo is better, but this was also pretty good.
It was pretty good. I'm glad we tried it, but I think from now on we'll go to Sojung Deo. First impressions of Pittsburgh.
It's nice. It's really...
Wait, where? Oh my god, there's an El Jefe!